Splashing out to the tropics to get a quick check on the two invests that we continue to monitor, the first of which is Invest 96L, which does not show prominent signs of further development. What it's going to do is continue to push north across the center of the Atlantic, but on its heels is Invest 97L. And with this westward projection, we could see a lot of changes happening within the next week or possible 2 weeks, in which we may have our next named storm and possibly our first hurricane of the season on our hands. So we do see that the development chance over the next 7 days sits at 90%. So there's a very high possibility that either tonight or as we move across the start of your work week, this tropical wave could become a tropical depression. Wind speeds are already sustained at 35 miles per hour, so we can check that box off. But as it continues to move north and towards the west at 18 mile per hour speeds, we will show this system moving over much warmer Atlantic waters. The warmer the water, well, the more ingredients that we'll have that could possibly allow for this system to continue to grow. But over the course of the next 2 weeks, we'll keep our eyes on both of these features here. Now, Invest 97L is just east of the Cabo Verde Islands, but typically, any feature that's just off the western tip of Africa, it's going to take about 12 to 14 days for any potential impacts to the United States. So still a long way to go, in which we could see multiple changes unfolding. But what we do know is that the water temperatures that it's moving across are anywhere between 4 to 6 degrees above their seasonal average. And as I mentioned just a second ago, the warmer the water, the more unstable the conditions are going to be. So as we move through the start of the work week, it's likely that we not only just have a depression on our hands, but Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, most models are hinting at this being our next named storm. Its name would be Aaron. But as we get towards the back end of the work week, look at what the intensity models are predicting. Not just a category one, some models leading towards category two or possibly even category three strength. If that holds to be true, this is the strongest system that we've seen so far in 2025. But what's going to direct it closer to us is all coming down to the positioning of this high pressure center, the Bermuda Azores High. When it's in the center of the Atlantic, we have a much quicker recurve towards the north. But the further out towards the west that this high pressure system does move, the more dramatic the impacts are going to be for potential landfall here across the Caribbean and even for the United States. Right now, that high pressure center is sitting towards the center of the Atlantic. So the spaghetti plots, as we track them over time through next Sunday, are showing this feature recurving towards the north, towards the Bermuda area. Hopefully that does play out. But of course, as we mentioned, there could be lots of changes happening between now and then, and we'll keep you up to date every step along the way. Right now here in Central Florida, we have seen numerous chances for flood activity as it's been a soggy weekend overall. From the I-75 corridor to I-95, we've seen these flood advisories, like this one in particular, across 528 for Orange and Osceola County. It looks like the rain is a lot more light right now, but that wasn't the case to start off the afternoon, in which we've piled up about 3 to 4 inches of rain just west of I-95. Out towards the west, though, Marion County, this is a flood advisory active until 7:45. So we got another 45 minutes on this particular feature here, in which we've seen about 2 to 3 inches of rain stack up so far. Elsewhere to the south, stronger showers moving across Lakeland, Polk City, and Polk County right along that I-4 corridor. As we head north and Sumter County, Bushnell, looks like Bay Lake and Lake County. You guys are in moderate rain currently, lighter showers though across I-4 as we switch gears heading towards Sanford, then Deltona and Volusia County. And we'll eventually see the rain come to an end right around 9, 10 o'clock. Mostly cloudy or partly cloudy skies are what's left behind for the majority of the evening. And then we're actually going to wake up to sunshine in some spots. Your launch forecast for tomorrow looks a lot better than it did today. We actually pushed back the Kuiper mission. Probability sits at 55% for us being green to go early out the door on Monday morning, which is going to be a great start for your back to school forecast. Small chance for some coastal showers. However, as we move into the afternoon, we'll see the chance for showers returning. So warmer to start off the work week. Eventually, this stationary boundary is going to lift, and that will open up the door for these winds from the south to increase your chance for some showers in the afternoon here and there. But overall, your rain trend is going to be a lot less significant as we move across the work week. So we're going back to school on Monday with that 60% shot at showers. Gradually over time, the chance for rain is coming down. Your temperatures, however, those are moving up. Look to return to the mid-90s starting on Wednesday, and we'll carry that trend all the way through your next weekend.